Yeah. Thanks for tuning in to Mic Check today. Show that's about information and about entertainment, which we have a little bit of both today with my guest today, Mr. Jay Lawrence, artist manager, consultant. So how did you get into the field of artist management and consulting, Jay?
Basically, I met a lot of artists years ago, and they just need a lot of push and somebody to really get around them and help them out with the music they was putting together. And with me knowing the business side, learning the business side, I kind of used that as a platform to kind of practice and get myself out there as well. And so they came to me and we bumped heads and made it happen and started moving, making moves.
Okay, so you you're telling me that you attended the MTSU music program and had the privilege of working with a couple of major labels around, I guess, in America or whatever.
Yeah.
So who are some of the labels you work with?
I work with Sony, Warner Music Group, and now I'm working on the publisher side here in Nashville. And we deal with Sony and Universal Music Publishing.
Okay, so you said that you got started, your motivation was helping a lot of these up-and-coming aspiring artists on the business side. Do you help producers as well, or are you strictly dedicated to recording artists?
Artists and producers, companies, record labels. A lot of guys have these labels, and they go out and make these chains, and you know, they go out and just try to look like a label, but they actually don't know what a label does, and I help put them together, marketing plans, budgeting with the artists and the labels and their producers, and help them get that paperwork done and just make them official, not just walking around wearing a chain.
I thought a chain made you a medallion and made you a label. But that's good, man. I'd like to commend you on stepping up to the plate, man, and spearheading a movement to educate people about the music business, right? Because it is changing a lot, and it has changed a lot, and it is changing. So what's some of the things that you see that's glaring out at you that's a major change?
A lot of music now is a lot of media based. There are a lot of outlets and things the artists need to take advantage of. For example, your show, having a media base and getting footage online and things like that where people can check you out and see how you sell yourself and see how you look and your imaging. A lot of artists are selling a lot of ringtones and downloads and things like that that really come into play now. It's not so much out on the street and selling out the trunks. A lot of it's media-based production now.
Okay. You mentioned like ringtones and things of that nature. Seemed like 10 years ago, I mean, that was totally unheard of. So I can see how a lot of the, I guess, subsidiaries of music and the residual of your CD is like generating other forms of income, not just the CD sales.
Exactly.
I mean, is that like important as far as like getting a deal structured to allow artists to make money off of that? Or how does that work? Does the record company share in those proceeds too?
Yeah, it's all deal based. I mean, the same deals that was given somewhat 10 years ago. They ain't really breaking deals like Master P them did back then, but all that is percentage based, ringtones, downloads, and all kind of digital sales and different outlets that they have online now that artists are taking advantage of and really promoting through different sites and things like that to really get noticed, and you start building them sales and record labels are looking to sign new artists.
Okay, so the more money that an artist invests in themselves on the front end, it's the less the labels have to invest on the back end. So like I was telling you earlier, a friend of mine, Big Gip, what's up, Big Gip, in ATL, he said that it's not necessarily that you're the best one out, it's the fact that you're the most ready.
Right.
So
right.
That pretty much means that you're taking steps to put yourself in position to get signed, or you've invested enough in yourself and in your craft to be signed.
Yeah, you gotta invest. If you're an independent artist, you gotta invest in yourself. If you don't invest, nobody's gonna invest in you. They wanna look and see what you can do on your own. It's like a lot of parents, you know, you was coming up and you wanted that car, but they looking at you like, oh, you ain't trying to work to get something to take care of something. So why should I invest a car in you and you're not gonna work?
That's
so it's the same difference.
And I've had privilege of attending the Next Step Music Seminar that you recently moderated here in town. How did that go? And from your end, and what was your motivation behind that?
The motivation behind it was basically having an outlet for a lot of artists to come and sit and really learn and get into the business. It wasn't so much of, yeah, I want to show off my music and DJ is going to be on the panel and I can bring my stuff and network. No, it was strictly business, where we went from A to, probably A to Z on a lot of things, and we're putting together more and bringing in different avenues. On this first seminar, we didn't have too many artists on the panel. We just had mainly DJs and media outlets, and every different seminar will have a different look on the panel to represent a different avenue of the music business.
Okay, along with DJ Weezy and DJ Rage, you had a couple of guys that organized a website here in town, So Cashville, which I've had a chance to log onto and check it out. It's a hot website, man. Yeah, Darquan and Sebo, man.
Yeah, shout out
to
them.
So, I mean, you're involved with that as well, right?
Yes, I'm their business management. My company, we basically oversee, set up our marketing and our strategies for the website. The website was built in September, and with no promotion, no anything. We haven't did a website release party, but we have over 1,000 members as of now.
I mean, it's a good looking, well, actually a great looking site, man. I looked at it, it looks really good. I mean, I think it's speaks a lot, you know, for Nashville and, you know, what we could do as far as putting our city on the map, you know, in certain areas.
Yes.
And, like I said before, I'd like to commend you on, you know, bringing that to the forefront and bringing your expertise.
Appreciate
a lot
it.
Of these young artists out here that's not really knowledgeable as far as the music business, and they got the hot songs but no paperwork. You
exactly.
Know?
Exactly.
So the paperwork is where you come in, right?
Yeah, getting the paperwork done, and it's real technical. A lot of these guys, they don't know when to copyright and when to do certain avenues of really putting a piece together, because a lot of these guys had these hot singles and they got them on radio and they ain't got no kind of paperwork done on them, and they don't understand they could be actually making money, income for their projects and things like that, and everything getting tallied up where your spends are calculated and things like that too. So
yeah, so if we want to get at you and find out about all the aspects of the business that you're into, how can we get in touch with you?
You can check out the MySpace. It's myspace.com/nextstepmusicmanagement. Or you can email me at jaylawrence.llc@gmail.com. And that's jlawrence.llc@gmail.com.
Okay, so you mentioned the Next Step Music Seminar. Do you are you in the planning stages of having another one?
Yeah, we're looking at a couple more colleges and platforms to really reach out. The first one was good, but I feel like the amount of artists that should have been there wasn't there. And we just got to find a bigger platform to really supply.
I'll make sure that once I get the date, I'll make sure I share with the 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 people who's watching this show. Make sure we get that information out there to the people, and let them know what's going on with Jay Lawrence and the Next Step Music Seminar. And you know, your management, are you open for to take on new clients, or if somebody's out here watching and they say, hey, I need this guy, I mean, are you open to taking on new clients to consult and manage?
Well, what we're doing now is we're promoting a seminar for consulting. So if you want to consult, you come to the seminar. I don't personally manage, I don't personally consult too many artists anymore. I think the seminar is a big enough platform and a way where I can reach a lot of artists, because if I personally consult a lot of artists around here, it'd be no time. There'd be no time for me to really do it. So,
well, speaking of time, I think we're about out, and I appreciate you coming down today and sharing your expertise and your skill level as far as you know, what you do in the music business and what you plan to do with your skills and your talents. And because a lot of times it's not about making that hot song, it's about having the people that's behind the scenes, making sure the I's are dotted and T's are crossed, and that's where
right.
You come in.
That's right. Yeah, exactly.
A lot of us forget about that. But I